First things first. Mastering English prefixes for first or primary. Hello, language learners. Welcome back to our series on advanced vocabulary in English, focusing on prefixes and suffixes. Today, we are going to discuss an important topic: prefixes for first or primary. These prefixes are crucial to enhance your English speaking and writing skills, especially when it comes to expressing ideas related to order or hierarchy. Let's get started. A prefix is a group of letters that we add at the beginning of a word to change its meaning. For instance, when we add the prefix un to the word happy, it becomes unhappy, meaning not happy. Now, when we talk about prefixes indicating the first or primary, we are referring to those prefixes that, when added to a word, suggest the idea of something being the first, principal, or most important. Now, let's dive into the specific prefixes. Here are three of the most common prefixes that indicate first or primary. 1. Proto. Proto is a prefix that comes from Greek and means first. This is often used in scientific and technical terms. For example, in the word prototype, proto means first and type means form. So a prototype is the first form of something. 2. Prim. Prim is a prefix that comes from Latin and means first. This can be seen in words like primary, primitive, and primordial. 3. Premier. Premier is another prefix that originates from Latin, and it also means first. We use this prefix in words like premiere, which refers to the first showing of a film or play. Let's see how to use these prefixes in sentences. 1. The proto-language of the Germanic languages was spoken over 2,000 years ago. 2. Education is a primary concern in many countries. 3. The premiere of the new Star Wars movie attracted fans from all over the world. And there you have it. These are the prefixes that can help you indicate something as being first or primary in English. Remember, mastering these prefixes will not only expand your vocabulary, but also make your communication more precise and expressive. So, keep practicing. I hope you found this video useful. Until next time, happy learning.